When it comes to energy consumption, AI is clearly part of the problem. It is the problem. But to what extent could it also be part of the solution? Speaking to me at ADIPEC, Jack Hidary, the CEO of SandboxAQ, a Google spin-off, told me he's optimistic about how AI could reshape the energy industry.
There's really two waves of AI. The first wave, I think all of our viewers know about, and that's the AI for the digital world. And that's ChatGPT and Google Gemini and many others that help us summarize documents and make marketing and customer service, the digital world, fantastic. But here at the energy conference, ADIPEC, we really have to talk about the next wave of AI, and that's AI for the physical world. A ChatGPT is not really the right tool if we want to take oil from the ground and turn it into useful products in the world. We need an AI not trained on Instagram and Reddit. We need an AI trained on chemistry and biology and physics. And that's, in fact, the AI for the physical world that's now upon us.
In other words, AI isn't just analyzing data anymore. It's beginning to shape the physical world itself. And that shift could change how everything from fuel to materials is made. Here's Jack Hidary again.
Just last week at the NVIDIA conference, we announced with NVIDIA a new AI model for catalysts. A big, big issue for all the energy companies here at ADIPEC is how do they make new products faster, better, cheaper? Compounds that help us speed up the reaction, reduce the energy we need for the reaction. If you're using a ballpoint pen, if you're sitting on a chair, if you have a table in front of you, you're using something that came from the use of a catalyst. And that's going to be a big, big use by the energy companies here, turning their hydrocarbons not so much in the future to fuels for cars, but for materials for our physical world. And that's going to be a big transformation of this industry.
But this transformation won't come cheap. In fact, it's going to demand investment on an unprecedented scale. So where's the money going to come from? Well, with private equity and infrastructure funds circling the energy sector, public-private partnerships are emerging as a key driver of change. And many of those deals are being brokered in the UAE, in majlis meetings where global investors and energy leaders are striking the partnerships that will power the next phase of the industry. Jack Hidary says he's energized by the progress he's seeing.
Capital markets have now stood up to the task. We had the Majlis, the Enact Majlis this Sunday, led by Dr. Sultan Al-Jaber. We had BlackRock there with a big, big energy infrastructure fund. We had many others there as well. Brookfield was another example of a big infrastructure player. They're deploying not millions, not billions, but trillions of dollars. And BlackRock, for example, has allocated about $2 trillion of its funds towards this kind of infrastructure. So the capital markets are ready, I believe, to start stepping up to the challenge. But we must really bring these two huge rivers together, the AI industry and the energy industry. And that's happening right here at ADIPEC.
And at ADIPEC, the message is clear. AI isn't just changing how the world uses energy. It's changing how the world produces it. And for investors, the race to power the AI age has only just begun.